What's up, divas? And what's up, divas? Of course, you know what time it is. It is Real Talk Wednesday. And your girl is sitting right here, fucking burning up, blazing hot. It's kind of hot. But anyway, so let's just get into this. Before you guys ask, what hair is that? I did release the video a few days ago. I think it was on Sunday. And it was the It's a Wig, Montessa. So today I have her pinned up just like I wore the Vanessa brand robust one, because it'd be hot. It'd just be too hot. So, yes. And I also got like a new fashion video coming out on Friday by this company called Zoffle, which I will post up. Well, it's already posted up, but it'll go live on Friday. Whatever. So today I thought I would try some different lipstick. Normally, I always wear the color pink. And if you guys know me really well, you know I love pink. I always wear the color pink. So, yes, I normally wear, like, the color pink. Isn't it, like, dark on one side of my face? Like, it is, like, super dark. Who cares? This is, like, a real talk. It's not even a tutorial. So, anyway, yes. So, I decided to try something new out today because I got a PR package in the mail from Milani, which I was loving. And I do have a video up. And this is their Amore Matte Metallic Lip Creams. There are 10 in the collection, and they sent me all 10. I will say this, they are very full coverage. They do have a very pretty color, but the scent smells god-awful. Like, it actually smells like Play-Doh on your lips. Like, seriously, Play-Doh. So, I really don't like the smell at all. But the color is really, really great. You know what I'm saying? And then they sent me their new Stay Put Matte 17-Hour Wear Liquid Liners. Now, first of all, you guys know, when I'm doing a makeup look video, I'm always bitching about I cannot do eyeliner because I have hooded eyes. And one side always comes out really well, which is this side. Or how about this? Both sides have come out really well, but they never seem to match, which will piss me off. And so it's really hard for me to do my eyeliner sometimes. So I have to use like the right technique, the right brush, and that's about it. So I really don't do liquid eyeliners too much. When I do, it's the actual LA Colors one for $1 because their brush is really good. But sometimes I slip up with that. And sometimes more than likely, 9 times out of 10, I'm using like a gel eyeliner with my own little brush because it always works out best for me. Well, this one right here, and I do like the markers too. This one though by Milani is like the bomb, okay? So they sent me 4 colors, dark brown, black, green, and purple. And let me tell you, the brush on these are like some type of sponge applicator type brush tip, okay? Do you guys see that? Like, so if you have an issue with doing any type of eyeliner, baby, get these. And they're so black. Like, oh, this is like perfectly black. Hopefully it shows up like that on camera because I don't want to look like a liar. You know what I mean? But it's like perfectly black. Like, look at that. Perfectly black. So the only thing is the liquid lipstick that I have on today is kind of like pale looking. But I really do not like the scent of these things. They're really pigmented. They're so pretty. But the stench is like god awful. Like, do you see that color? So pretty. It's a beautiful color, but the smell is like, it just smells like Play-Doh. You guys ever smell Play-Doh as a kid growing up or just Play-Doh in general? It reminds me of the scent of Play-Doh. So the one that I have on right now is called Chromatic Addict, and like I said, they're really pretty colors, but gosh, if you can stand the smell, I mean, you're not gonna go around doing that all day. I would hope not, but oh god. And I feel like I got like a pale lip going on. Okay. So that's a little bit better because I was looking kind of sickly. And so this one here is called Pure Matteness. This is a really pretty color. Look at that. It's like a brownish kind of color. Really pretty brown, kind of like browny, bronzy color. It's pretty though. But ooh, the smell is like, But the intensity of it is gorgeous. So yeah, so I got those. And then we went to Walmart today. Not Walmart, excuse me, Target. Because today is Mumsy's birthday. Because today is Tuesday. I record on Tuesdays, sometimes Mondays. So by the time this goes up, it'll be Wednesday. But, you know, today's Mumsy's birthday. And she wanted some of the new Legos out. If you guys have kids that play with Legos, then you know they are not cheap. They are not cheap anymore. So she loves the Friends one. Sometimes she gets like the boy ones. But she loves the Friends collection of Legos. And she has like, oh my god, probably like almost every last one. So thank you, Legos, for coming out with some new shit. This is like the Carnival Amusement Park one. And so there are different little sets in the collection. And the other sets are like $20, $40, $50. The one that has the most, which has the roller coaster and all, of course that's $100. And of course, Mumsy wanted the most expensive one. So I made sure to get her that. We was at Target and we got that. And then I seen these eyelashes by Allure London. I was going to get the Vegas Nay ones, but they were $7.99. They're $10 at Ulta. But I found these ones for $4.99 at Target, which is also by Allure. Because Vegas Nays is by Allure too. But these ones here are the number 126s. And these are the definition ones by Allure. Allure London, and these were $4.99. It comes with an applicator, glue, and these banging ass lashes. And so I don't normally do strips at all, but these, let me take them out the plastic. These were so freaking like, oh man, so pretty. And for $4.99, I could not pass these up. And you probably can't see how freaking pretty they are. But these things are like gorgeous. Like they are so pretty. Do you see those? And there's the glue and the applicator right there. I hate when my camera just like does the most. Not even the camera, but the light. So I got those. And you guys know I'm like a huge clearance girl. I don't really shop unless it's on a dime or like clearance. Because I just really don't believe in spending like a lot of money. So here it's always hot. It's going to be hot here until the end of October. And I cannot wait. And it's still going to be kind of hot, but not like 118 degrees hot. So they have a lot of sandals on clearance at Target, which I'm good for. I love some good sandals, especially if they're $6. So these were originally $23. And I'm not really sure the brand, but these are called DVs. So I got them for $6.48. They're just plain, but they're really cute. I thought these were so freaking cute. They also came in silver. They have a zipper on the back. And I thought they were so cute. Like, you know what I'm saying? And then the last pair we can get into this were these. These were originally $35. Your girl got these for $10.48, which are these gladiator sandals. I'm just going to take the strap off. So they had two pairs left. My size, which is a size 11, and my daughter Tati's size, which is a size 9. So I bought the last two pair because she liked them as well. They both were in this color. They're by the Mosimo brand. And yes, they were $10. They zip up in the back. They have the thing in the front. For $10, I really, really like these. They're comfortable. So $10, you guys. So make sure you check out Target because they have like a load of stuff on clearance. I also got some shirts for my grandson, Tinky. Some short sleeve shirts and some shorts for $2. And I bought them a couple sizes too big so he can wear them for next year because he doesn't need them right now. So, yeah. So, other than that, let's get on to this real talk. If you have a real talk that you want to talk about, you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please make sure to put in the subject line real talk so that way I know it is official real talk and not no bullshit. Also, if you want to change the names in your email or your story, say your name is Gabby and you don't want to let everyone know, you can always change your name and just let me know. If you don't change your name, then I'm just going to assume that you want me to rename you. And that's normally what I'll do. So yeah, so let's get into this real talk, you guys. All right. Okay, so I'm going to try to do three because like I said, it's Mumsy's birthday and I really would like to go downstairs and spend some time with her. So yeah. So please. So we're just going to call her Gabby. I have been wanting to tell you my story for a long time. So me and my BF have been knowing each other for 19 years and been together for 9. So BF, I guess, means boyfriend. All right. So me and my boyfriend have been knowing one another for 19 years, and we have been together for 9 years. We have one kid together. Just recently, I found out my boyfriend has been talking to some Chinese bitch. So before that, he told me I want to take a break and I need some time apart. Mind you, this been going on for 2 weeks. Meanwhile, we still sleeping together, and he telling me nobody comes before us. It's just he's tired of arguing. Whatever, I didn't believe him. We've been through worse. So once I caught on to the bitch on his Facebook page, liking all of him and my son's pictures, I messaged her. She responded, "Yeah, we've been talking, and I'm sorry to break up your family." Laugh out loud, like, what? So I call him at work. Mind you, we live together. He denies everything. And then I had so much proof, he told me he slept with her. That same night, he came home early and called her and told her he's not fucking with her no more and he wants his family to work. I wasn't having it, and I was done with his ass. He ended up buying me a brand new car with 11 miles, and it's a 2015. Then Christmas Day, I'm looking in his phone, and I see he was texting the same girl again. So at this point, I go off on him because at this point, I found out that I'm pregnant again. I lied, and I told him I was sleeping with someone, too. He got so crazy, he got caught and got himself locked up. I was so confused, like he tore me down as a woman for an ugly bitch, talking about I treat him like a little boy. He has been begging for his family, but I can't get over the fact that he has been cheating on me. What type of woman talks to a man again after he tells you in front of me he's not fucking with her no more? I hate when women try to make it seem like the home girlfriend got played. Like, no, we both got played. The only difference is I have kids, a history, and he pays all my bills. Like, why even keep trying for a man like that? I think the only reason I kept coming back was for the money. Please help. Okay, Gabby. So basically, Gabby has been with this dude for 9 years. They've been knowing each other for 19. They have one kid, or maybe they have two by now. I'm not really sure. But she resent me the message again on August the 2nd because I didn't respond in time. So dude started cheating on her, like she said, with some Chinese bitch, Asian bitch, whatever. This big, fuck the race card, some bitch, okay? Some bitch. So she found this out because the bitch been liking all his pictures on Facebook with him and his son. And she confronted the girl, and the girl was like, "Yeah, I've been messing with him. Laugh out loud. Sorry to break your home." Okay, now here's the thing. This is just me. I'm just saying. If you know dude got a girlfriend, but you still want to interfere, you still want to fuck with the nigga, then there is no reason why you shouldn't get your ass whooped. Now, if you fucking bitch don't know that he had a girl and a family at home and you were just that naive to it and you didn't know, then okay, we gonna let you slide. Like, you know, you get that pass. You know, like a Monopoly, you get that pass. You got one pass. So we gonna let you get that non-ass whipping pass. Okay, you gonna get that one pass. However, if y'all trifling bitches know that he got a girl, the dude got a girl or wife, whatever, know he's in a situation with somebody, but you still want to come through and you still want to holler and you still want to interfere with his home, then by all means, that pass is now invalid, which means your ass is going to get kicked. You're going to get fucked up, all right? I feel like you deserve to get fucked up, okay? The both of you, the man and the woman, you know what I'm saying? And I don't think it's funny that when women are so trifling that they really don't give a fuck about the last girl. And you know what's so crazy about it? She is right. Gabby is right. The mistress, because that's what the fuck you are. You are the mistress. You the side chick because he lives at home with me and he buys cars for me. He pays my bills. He does everything for me. You feel like me, the one that lives at home with him, is getting played. No, bitch, you're the one getting played. Let's just think about it in the long run. He's coming home. He's paying all my bills. He's taking care of his family. And he's calling you up and telling you I ain't fucking with you no more. So you think that I got played because he cheated on me with your lame ass? Okay, have you ever stopped to think, bitches, if you the side chick and you know you the side chick, listen to what I'm saying right now. Have y'all ever started, and I'm talking to the side chicks, the side chicks that know they the side chicks and are acceptable to it, who don't care, who want to be the side chick, who know they man got a girl at home, but they are okay with being a side chick. I'm talking to y'all bitches. Have y'all ever stopped and thought, I'm a side chick? That's like when you have a main course meal. Main course meal. And they be like, well, what do you want for your sides? Because the main course is the best thing. They're going to just throw on some sides. Could be like some french fries, a biscuit, some rice. But the main course is like some lobster tails, some fucking good ass steak, filet mignon. It's like some real deal. And it's the real deal. This is the main course, the main meal. And then you got them sides that they throw on, which is like always whack. You know what I'm saying? Salad, some fries and biscuits or whatever. But the main course is always the best course. So do y'all side chicks ever think about it like that? Like, let me think about it. If I go out to one of these fancy ass restaurants, that shit don't even gotta be that fancy. It could be like Red Lobster. And they like, well, what do you want for your sides? But the main shit is like the bomb shit. Shrimp, lobster. It's the most expensive. Then you gonna throw in some baked potato or some french fry wedges and some shit like that. So you ever think about yourself as a side dish? Because when you look at the motherfucking side dishes, they ain't too fucking healthy. They ain't like, oh my God, yes, give me some french fries, please. They ain't all of that, because the main shit is what I came there for, the main shit, which is that lobster tail, that steak. This the shit that I came for. Yeah, just throwing the sides, whatever. That's what y'all bitches are, okay? That's what y'all side chicks are. Y'all some thrown in side orders. Like some side chicks. That's what the fuck y'all are. I came for the main shit, the main course meal. Not for no sides. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, you got to get the sides, because what the fuck else you going to have with the main course? Y'all are really not irrelevant, not important. So when y'all feel like y'all dissing, or like the main course meal has gotten dissed because he went to the sides, bitch, no. You're temporarily. At the end of the night, nobody's bragging about them side fries, them side rices, the mashed potatoes. They talking about how good that main course meal was. And that goes to say in the same thing in the sense of a real world. Yeah, your nigga might be cheating, or my nigga might be cheating on one of y'all, on me, with you side bitch. But at the end of the day, he still come home and he still pay his bills and he do everything for me. So why the fuck do you side chicks always feel like, oh, the main course meal that's at home is the one getting dissed? Yeah, we are the ones that's getting dissed. Now, I'm not saying we. I'm just using me as an example just so you side chicks can understand. Because sometimes y'all bitches really don't understand, because if y'all really was understanding, and then y'all would know what the fuck I'm talking about, y'all wouldn't want to be no side chick. But yeah, we might be the ones getting dissed, you know what I'm saying? And he cheating on us, because it's not right to cheat regardless. But you got to realize, you the side chick, you really not that important. You're really not that relevant to the situation. You on the sidelines, bitch. What you waiting for him to leave his main course meal? And how about this? Do you really think like the man is going to leave his main course meal for some side shit? Like me personally, I would not leave no lobster tail for no fucking french fry wedges. Crazy. They french fry wedges is good, but damn, they not that great, okay? And sometimes, like, the side chicks, they might do a little bit more. They are a little bit more acceptable because they side chicks. And they just, that's all. They really are side chicks, okay? So, at the end of the day, cheating is not right. Neither here nor there. It's just not right. However, the side chicks really do need to stop feeling like they are so relevant and that we are the ones that's gotten this. Because at the end of the night, afternoon, morning, whatever, y'all both got motherfucking dissed, okay? By some nigga that really ain't worth your time. Now, y'all ain't together, Gabby, and he's begging for his family back. Continue to let him beg, okay? Sometimes you, even if you want to be with the man, okay, not saying you do, not saying you don't, but even if you per se want to be with him, sometimes you gotta let them grovel and beg, okay? You gotta let them crawl on their knees and let them see the good thing that they've missed out on and all the great things that they've missed out on because of the side chick, because of them french fry wedges. Like, really, nigga? Dude. So, if you still want to be with him, that's great, but don't go running back into his arms like it's the best thing in the world. You know what I'm saying? Good, he bought you a car. He just ought to have bought you a car. You pregnant and you have one of his children already. You deserve that. And if he bought you the car because he felt guilty, oh, fucking well. 11 miles? I wish a motherfucker would buy me a car that only had 11 miles. I might just be the side chick, okay? I mean, but I'm saying, if you a side chick and you getting all of that, then just continue to be the side chick. You're getting some benefits with it. Some side chicks do get really great benefits, okay? But, you know, those are still, they're still a little stupid because they still feel like I'm going to go and ruin this for myself. Bitches, wisen up, okay? This is 2016. Wisen the fuck up. Whether you're a side chick or not, wise the fuck up, okay? We all have to wise up sometimes. Sometimes I'm dumbing out. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I dumb out. But, yeah, Gabby, regardless if she's Chinese or whatever, she didn't win and you didn't win. But I'm going to be all Team Gabby because at the end of the night, you kind of won more than she has. She's got nothing but some fucking Facebook likes and messages. And you've got a car, two children, and him groveling at your knees. I love when a man grovels. It's like the best thing in the world sometimes to make them grovel and beg. Regardless if you have forgiven them already and if you still want to be with them, it's cool to make them grovel sometimes because they deserve it. They put us through enough dumb shit. Make them beg and make them feel like you are so worthy of groveling and begging. And that's how I feel about it. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, continue to let them grovel and beg. Don't give in just that fast. You got a family to take care of and think about. And along with that, you got some sanity. So child, please, let that nigga keep begging. Let him keep telling you how he want his family back. I used to love when my husband would grovel and beg. And I would have forgave him already. But it just something about you begging and kissing my ass and brown nosing me. It just makes me feel like I'm on top of the world sometimes. Like, serious. So let's get on to the next one. Okay. Let's see how long this one is. Okay. Hey, April. For the purpose of this letter, you can call me Trinity. I really don't know if you can help me or give me some advice because this is kind of embarrassing and I'm really feeling guilty and like a liar. Backstory. When I was 16, I ran away from home because my mom and I had a very rocky relationship. And like all teenagers, I thought I knew what was best for my life. Yeah, they all do. During that time I had ran away, I lost my virginity by being raped to a person I considered a friend. I was devastated and didn't know what to do. I ended up going back home, and a few weeks later I found out I was pregnant. I never told anyone what happened to me. I haven't seen or spoken to the guy who raped me since that day, and that was 30 years ago. I've since been married and divorced, and I have a total of 4 beautiful grown children with some beautiful grandkids sprinkled in. Now for my issue. I hate sex. I have never, and when I say never, I mean never, had an orgasm with a man. I'm the queen of faking it. I make all the necessary sounds and movements that make a man think he is caving my back in. But in reality, all I'm thinking about is him getting the hell off of me. Or are you finished yet? I remember a time I was actually peeling my fingernail polish off because I was so ready for him to get off of me. And when he looked up, of course I went into acting mode. I'm with a wonderful man of over 8 years who knows all about my past. He is very gentle, caring, and understanding. He always says if he had one wish, he would erase my past and take all the pain away. He has no idea that I'm faking it with him, and my question is, should I tell him? I don't really want to hurt his feelings because other than sex, the relationship is wonderful. We are even talking marriage. I know I still carry the pain of my rape with me, and I know that this is why I hate sex. I've even went to a counselor, and it hasn't helped. I'm afraid if I tell him how I truly feel about sex, it will damage our relationship. He's a very sensual and sexual man, and I don't want to mess up a great thing because of my hang-ups. To be honest, I could fake it for the rest of my life and be cool with it, but is that fair to him? I'm lost, hurt, and confused. Any advice would be really appreciated. Blessings. Wow. So, unfortunately, Trinity was raped at a very young age, at 16, and from that, you know, she has not enjoyed sex, but she has 4 beautiful children and some grandchildren sprinkled throughout, and she has been divorced and married, like I said, and she has been faking it for all these years. She has never had, and she says, never had an orgasm. Now, she's been with someone for 8 years, and he's a wonderful guy. She has been faking it all this time. And she feels embarrassed and she feels like a liar. And they are even talking marriage. And he's a great person. If he could erase her past, he would, etc., etc. But she feels bad and she doesn't know if she should tell him or not. Me, honestly, I really, really don't feel like you should tell him, Trinity. Some things are just left better not known, honestly. And in this situation, this might be the situation where it's better left unknown. Like, if you were to tell him, what are you going to gain from it? Are you going to have an orgasm because you told him? No. You're going to gain nothing. You may not have a man anymore, and you might lose that person that you really, really care about. You know what I'm saying? As well as you may really hurt him emotionally and scar him. And that is kind of offsetting to men's egos when they find out that a woman has been faking it for all these years, 8 years. He may find that like really, really bitter towards himself as a man. You know what I'm saying? He might feel like he hasn't been doing his job all this time. And then in return, he could lash out in all different types of ways. He can feel like, oh, well, you know what? Maybe I should go hit up somebody else because maybe they'll appreciate it. And I bet you I can get them to have an orgasm. Or better yet, he could just feel like, you know what? I'm less of a man. I really don't want to fuck with you no more. Let me tell you something. We have all faked it. I'm pretty sure we have all. And if you think you the queen of faking shit, then bitch, sit back and relax, because I am. What about the last asshole that I had, okay? Not the white boy, because I didn't have sex with him, but the one that was living with me, okay? First of all, like I told you, he was like 3 minutes, okay? And 3 minutes is just like, oh, okay. And I don't know if it shrunk because he gained so much weight. Because when we were in our 20s, it wasn't like that. But he would do all kind of things, like ask me questions about, was he bigger than my husband, my ex-husband? No, you know what I'm saying? Why are you asking me shit like that? But no, you weren't. Because I had to later on tell him, no, you're not. Because he just insisted. And I would fake it a lot with him. The movements, the noises. But the one thing that I would hate the most, they'll know if you're faking or not. Because if your pussy ain't getting wet and you have not come, they're going to be like, damn, girl, when did you come? Did you come? If he's asking you that, what do you say? You know, I would get so embarrassed when my ex would be like, did you come? And I would just be like, oh, just a little bit. And it seemed like just me even saying just a little bit was disappointing to him. Like, it hurt his ego. You can't eat pussy right, you can't finger right, you can't fuck right. He couldn't do any of those things right, okay? It was just like a big, huge turnoff. And it's sad to say when you gotta sit there and imagine all type of other shit just to get off, you know what I'm saying, with somebody that you've been faking it with all these times. So I totally understand. But you know what? I started getting really frustrated myself because I've had orgasms before, and a bitch don't like to fake it after a while. It's like, okay, who we in this for, you or me? Because I ain't really getting nothing out of this. Not a goddamn thing. So I started just telling him, like, you know, you don't last long enough. You're really not satisfying me. But I wouldn't say it mean. I would say it in a way that would make him feel comfortable. But I guess neither way would make anybody feel comfortable if you told him your dick don't work right. How are you really supposed to feel about that? Like, yeah, your dick don't work. So I'm sorry. Not really know what to tell you, but your dick don't work. And neither does your fucking tongue, okay? So, I mean, like, me personally, you guys got a great relationship. And like he said, if he could erase your past, he would. I really would not go and tell him, hey, Freddie, I've been faking it since these past 8 years. He would probably feel like it's the end of the world. Not only will he feel like you have lied about that for all this time, but he would feel like you have lied about so many other things that you probably never even lied. He would start to think like you've probably cheated on him and you've lied. One little slip up that you want to tell him that you have never had an orgasm and you've been faking it will open up a door, like a gateway to another world that you just don't want to fucking go in. You know what I'm saying? That is the key to opening up Pandora's box, okay? Don't open that shit. Do not. But what I'm going to need you to do, girlfriend, is even if you have already been to counseling and it is something that's eaten away at you. And I'm going to tell you this, having an orgasm it can be the best damn thing in the world. And it's sometimes just like you feel, I felt that way too. Like, could you just hurry up and get the fuck up off of me? Not with just this asshole. I felt like that all the time. I was making shit up then. You know what I'm saying? I don't feel good. Oh, my allergies are killing me. I would start saying all kind of shit because I really didn't feel like wasting 3 minutes of my time and you breathing on me. You know what I'm saying? rolling my eyes at the top of my head. But I get it, you know. Even with my ex-husband who really knew how to, like, sometimes I would feel the same way, like, could you just get the fuck up off of me? Because I'm really not into the mood of it right now. I just want to go the fuck to sleep. I'm tired. And I'd be feeling like that. But I'm going to need you to relax. Honey, let me tell you something. I don't know if you smoke weed. I'm not condoning any type of drugs. But there would be times when I just wasn't in the mood and my ex-husband would be in the mood. And I would hit up my bong. Well, I didn't have a bong. I had, I had an L. But you get the point of what I'm saying, okay? And I would feel kind of nice. And I would feel also good. So maybe you need to relax a little bit. Get you a bong. Just hit that shit like twice. Your whole body will feel so much different. And your muscles will feel so much more relaxed. And maybe you can get off and don't have to fake anything. But you also need to stop thinking about your past. It is a past and it was some time ago. And anything can scar a person. A person's life can be very traumatic. It's scarring of the mind and all types of things. But you're going to have to let go of that. And if a counselor hasn't helped, that's fine. However, what you would need to do, and he seems like the perfect person to talk to because he's already said he would erase your past. Maybe you need to sit down with him. But please, whatever you do, Trinity, don't hint on to, yeah, nigga, I've been faking it all these years. You don't want to do that. That will really hurt his ego. And like I said, you opening up a whole new door to some different world that you really, 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 really don't want to open up to. So I would say not to tell him, but to try to relax yourself and think about other things. Because if you're in the middle of having sex and what you're thinking about is not enjoying it, because it seems like you're thinking about not enjoying it, because you're sitting there laying there rubbing your nail polish off, thinking about how he just get the fuck off of you, how you faked it, how you've been raped. You're thinking about all of these things and obviously you're not going to enjoy it. I mean, I would go through some shit in life and I would be thinking about, okay. I would be thinking about money sometimes while I was having sex. Like, goddamn, I gotta get these wigs done. I got money. I gotta get made. And I would be thinking about that in the middle of, like, having sex or him eating me. Like, these are the things that I would think about. So that would just deter my whole mood. So you have to relax. And I'm gonna just tell you, light it up, girl, and relax a little bit. You know what I'm saying? That shit used to make me feel so much better. Of course, it is with a mixture of the weed and the dick, but it works out. Sometimes it really works out, whether you believe it or not. But yeah, let Trinity know, ladies, like, what would you do? So, this is going to be the last one. And she said, I apologize if this is extremely long. Well, I'm glad you know that, Diva. I am glad you know. So it goes down in the DM. Y'all know it be going down in the DM. Hi, Miss Muffin is my lover. Sorry if this is extremely long, but I'm going to give you a backstory. I need help for sure. Cut this down if you need to, if you're going to put it in a real talk video. Again, I apologize if it's so long. I have a situation that I want to fix, but I have no idea how to since I am blocked on everything by my recent ex. Backtracking to last year, we met each other at school. He had a girlfriend and I was in a 3-year relationship with someone else. He ended up talking to me, flirting with me, and I tried to keep my cool about it. So I ended up stopping the communication between us because I didn't want to ruin my 3-year relationship. I ended up breaking that off before talking to him again. So basically, she ended her 3-year relationship. Last February, he added me back on Instagram because he unfriended me for some reason. He commented on my photo calling me beautiful and all that corny romantic shit. So I ended up DMing him, asking him how's he been, and we took it from there. He moved on to a different school away from me in Boston, and his family moved there as well, so they don't live near me anymore. He came back to where I lived to visit me and to have our first real date, and it all went very well from there. I ended up going to Boston at one point and spent the night over at his house. And that's when the feelings kicked in. Let's just say he treated me really different from my 3-year relationship partner. He was so dreamy, nice, with a great personality. After the Boston trip, he seemed a little depressed that he couldn't see me, and that's when the communication started sinking a little. The conversation was forced on my end because all I wanted to do was keep this going because I fell head over heels for this guy. I did visit him after the Boston trip, and he felt really happy when I was around him. He acts really different when I'm face-to-face with him. But after that trip, the conversations through text started sinking even more. It was like pulling teeth to get an answer out of him. I could tell something was up. By the middle of May, he ended up saying he never wanted to talk to me again, and that's when my heart sank. He was moving with his family to Florida, so he couldn't keep up the texting and Skyping. I lashed out at him for ignoring me, saying, "Go fuck yourself," and that's it. After that statement, he blocked me on everything social media. I realized I shouldn't have done that, and I regret even saying that. Those words, "I don't think it's right if we talk again," hurt, especially when, we had chemistry with one another. It's been 2 months since then, maybe more, but I'm still torn apart about all of this. I've tried to get my mind off of it, whether it's with hanging with friends, dating other people, or playing sports. But at night, he appears in my dreams or late night thinking of him. I really want this to work out, but I don't know what to do. Recently, I did something stupid and made my friend follow him on Instagram so I could see what he's been up to. He liked the pictures I commented on. Then after a day or two, he then ended up blocking my friend. I feel like I'm in the worst situation. I don't want to be humiliated if I try to reach out to him to apologize for my actions. Is there any way around this? Thank you for listening. I love your videos. Best regards. We're going to call her Lisa because that's her real name. So Lisa basically was in a 3-year relationship with somebody, and she knew this guy that was at her school, and they started liking one another. Well, she broke the communication off with that guy at the school because she didn't want to do the wrong thing and start talking to somebody else when she was already in a 3-year committed relationship. Well, Lisa broke up with the 3-year committed relationship. Her and this guy got together, and things went from there. They would talk, text, go visit one another. I take it they lived in different states. Now, she never said anything about him and her having sex. I'm not really sure how that is. So if you guys are wondering, don't ask me. Okay. But anyway, she's met his family, et cetera, et cetera. She's fell head over heels for the dude. He treats her really, really great. But the communication started sinking. It wasn't like it was in the beginning after she went over there and visited him in Boston. And then the text messages started getting less too after a couple of visits. So my thing is this. She probably did give him some ass because sometimes the men seem like they'll put their all into trying to get the ass. Like, they'll make it seem like you're the only person in this world that they're thinking of, they're looking at, you know what I'm saying, that they want. Until they get the pussy, and then it's like the lack of communication or the lack of interest kind of deflates somewhat. You know what I'm saying? Slowly a deflating tire. However, he done went and told her, "I don't want to text or talk to you anymore," because he's moving to Florida. And then she told him to go fuck herself, and he blocked her. So she feels bad for telling him to go fuck himself, but why did she tell him to go fuck himself? Because he told her he don't want to talk or Skype anymore. I'm sorry, but if you tell me you don't want to talk to me no more and you don't want to Skype me no more and all of this, you don't basically be bothered with me anymore after I done came and gave you the goods and I've been visiting you and been communicating with you and everything was all good and I fell head over heels for you and my heart is throbbing for you, and then you're going to turn around and tell me, "Bitch, I don't want to fuck with you no more," basically. You damn right go fuck yourself. What I would have said, me, I wouldn't have said go fuck yourself. I would have said, "Bitch, you can go kill yourself, okay? Go in the corner and die real slow, nigga. Fuck you and your family." That's what I would have said. Not go fuck yourself. So she was being really polite by saying go fuck yourself. But did he block her because she said go fuck yourself? Here's the thing. He could block me all day. You better motherfucking block my ass, okay? If you know what's good for you. And why is you getting so emotional, dude? You just told this girl that you don't want to basically fuck with her no more. You want to break up all ties of communication. But when she tell you to go fuck yourself, you're going to act like a pansy and act all emotional and shit and start crying and go and blocking motherfuckers. Females normally block bitches on Instagram and all kind of social media. Dudes don't really do that too much unless they really in their feelings. So what is he in his feelings about? You told her to go fuck herself, basically. If you tell someone, I don't want to talk to you, I don't want to Skype you, I don't want to FaceTime you or anything, that's you telling them, go fuck yourself, okay? And in return, I'm going to tell you back, go fuck yourself. And then you're going to be like, I'm never going to speak to you again. Okay, Lisa, this is what you need to do. You're only dreaming of him is because you're thinking about him. That's the issue. And I know this for a fact because when me and my ex-husband would get into altercations and arguments and then I would kick him out, I would think about him all the time. And then every night I would have a dream about him. But when we were together, I never dreamt of the nigga. But then when we were going through some shit, I always would have a dream of him. It would be some fucked up dreams sometimes and sometimes it wouldn't. But that is your mind fucking with you because you are thinking of dude. Now, here's the thing. You are going to humiliate yourself if you are chasing behind him. If he told you that he don't want to talk to you no more and he don't want any communication with him, tell him to go fuck himself. Yes, fuck you. Go fuck yourself. Don't, you're not all that. You are not God's gift to woman or mankind, okay? Don't nobody got to run behind you and chase behind you like we little puppies here. It is what it is. Now, I'm sorry. Sometimes we do fall head over heels for a nigga. And we get caught up in our feelings. Yes, I do know that feeling. Trust me, I know the feeling. However, sometimes we gotta put ourselves in stability mode, okay? Because as long as you allow these motherfuckers to put you in a mindset where you really, really feeling them and you gonna fall head over heels for them and you in your feelings for them, then bitch, you gonna be in your motherfucking feelings for them. And that's where you gonna be the fucked up one, okay? You. So the best thing for you to do is to back the fuck up off of him. Don't be having your friends follow him on social media and commenting on his pictures and whatever. That looks like you're fucking stalking him and you're being really desperate, okay? You never want a man to know how you truly feel sometimes because they just use that as a scapegoat and they run with that shit. Just like what I just said to you in the beginning of this video. How I would love him when my ex-husband would grovel and beg. Even though I already forgave him, I would still love to watch him brown nose. That's the same thing. I'm going to run with it. If you want to apologize and grovel and beg, I'm going to run with that shit. I'm going to fucking take it and I'm going to run that shit in the motherfucking ground. That's what I'm going to do. And so that's what men do. Especially when you're doing crazy things like jumping out of the bushes. Because that's kind of like you jumping out the goddamn bushes. You got your friends following him. That bitch don't give a fuck about what he's been doing. And you're basically doing this to keep up with him and see what the fuck he's doing. Nigga lives in another state. Who gives a fuck what he's doing, okay? He told you to go fuck yourself, okay? He told you he don't want to Skype you. He don't want to call you. He don't want to text with you. He don't want to fuck with you. And what you told him was to go fuck himself. Now the next time, tell a nigga to go kill himself, okay? That's what you should do. Stop following him and chasing behind him. That's what you need to stop doing. Once you get him out of your system, then you will not be dreaming of that nigga. Okay, trust and believe. You are thinking about him too much, and that's why you
dream. Okay, so thanks to my memory card for getting full. But like I was saying, your ass is dreaming of him because you're thinking of him. And that's just the bottom line.
So, yes, get him out of your mind, girl. Stop it. Go hang out with your friends and stop thinking about that nigga. Trust me when I tell you, there are so many other men out there in the world. We get caught up in these ones that really don't want anything to do with us. And we let the great ones bypass us. And that's why bitches that really don't even deserve these niggas, get them. You know what I'm saying? Be them side chicks that get them. So yes, he's not worthy of your time. He told you to go fuck yourself. So go fuck yourself, girl. All right? So on that note, I'm going to go downstairs and hang out with my mumsy, even though she's probably not going to pay me any attention because she's got her Lego thing going on. But it is birthday time, so yes. So, yes, on that note, make sure you rate, comment, subscribe to my channel. Share this video with whomever. And as always, stay diva and divalicious. And I'll see you girls and guys on my next video.